Hello and welcome to Open Everyone. I'm Rina Valentin, your hosty Cafe con Leche for the next hour. Always inviting you to get social with us online, that is. Tweet us and follow us on Instagram at Broxnet TV or like us on Facebook at Open Broxnet Television. And of course, don't forget while you're there, follow moi on Twitter, FB, Instagram, Insta Stories, LinkedIn. I'm still considering Snapchat, pero why not? It's Snapchat at Rina Valentin. All right, so our first guest earned her law degree in Caracas, Venezuela, and through rediscovering her love for writing, became an artistic director and media expert, bringing the arts to her community in Queens. And through her production company, Wendy Angulo Productions, she has been able to converge and produce content that uses words as a healing modality. And most recently, she became the interim director of VONA, also known as Voices of Our Nation's Arts Foundation, where she's committed to amplify the voices of writers of color. And joining us to share more, we welcome Wendy Angulo.
Thank you.
Hello and welcome. Hello.
Thank you. Thank you for having me. Super excited to be here.
We are excited to have you here. It's about time.
You know?
You've been doing some really excellent work. And I got to tell you, you know, it's important that everybody get a little bit of the background of what it is, I guess, that allowed you to catch the bug. I call it the bug, right? Because here you are, you study law, you're a lawyer, although you're paralegal here, but you're a lawyer. And so there's that court aspect, that serious aspect, that corporate aspect of life. And then you kind of convert into being somewhat of an artist, right? Even though you're on the production side, you're still exercising artistry. What happened there?
Well, you know, I've been a writer all my life, since I was 7 years old, and I always balance the art with my corporate. And when I came to New York, I had that bug, like you said. I was invited to an open mic, and that's where I realized this is really my passion, so I'm going to pursue it. And it has been my side hustle, and now I'm moving to just do it 24/7.
Just doing it all, that's what you do, like as your primary source of revenue.
Yes.
I get it, right?
Yes. Because
when you're in this field, you kind of have to have your hands in a lot of places, right? So did you grow up in Venezuela?
Yes, I was raised in Caracas, Venezuela, and I returned to the U.S. in 1998.
So how was that for you, just transitioning?
Well, it was a cultural shock, you know, because for me, I always consider myself Latina, but then when you come here, you're like in a box, you're a box that you check, so that was a little shocking for me, but then I just have worked through it, and it has been my commitment to amplify our voices and share our stories because we matter and they're important, and that has been my commitment with the work that I do artistically.
I love it, I love it, and so let's talk about your artistic work, right? So with the writing, you went from writing. I understand also that you used to do the program directing for the Latinas Writers, right?
Yeah, the New York City Latina Writers Group.
The New York City Latinas Writers Group. And then you designed your own production company.
Yes.
Right? And in within your own production company, you also have the reason I chose to say that you use words as a means of healing modalities because the topics that you choose to to produce.
Yes. Because I feel that at the end, pain, we all can relate to pain because we all have suffered pain and we use art to interconnect with other people through the pain. Art is a beautiful way to talk about pain and share our pain with other people and then connect with them through that pain. So that's what I've been doing, you know, through my writing. I write a lot of personal essays and I share my personal experience. So the New York City Latina Writers Group was my home. There they push me, they encourage me to then create my production company. And then through my production company, I had been connected with other artists and we have been connected through our pain. So I always felt like this is a good way to use the art as healing because then when we can relate to other people, we know that we're not alone.
Exactly.
And that we belong.
Right. And as people of color, we all have similarities in our differences.
Yes.
Right.
Absolutely.
And so leading to your newfound position as interim director.
Program director.
Program director for VONA.
Yes.
Yes. Let's talk a little bit about how that happened.
Oh, my God. That was, I'm still.
Because you graduated from VONA, right?
Yes, so I was a VONA alum.
Let's share with everybody what VONA is and the process, because I know you have to be selected in order to,
yes,
to attend.
Well, VONA, it's the only multi-genre workshop for writers of colors. That it was created in 1999 by Juno Diaz, Elmas Abinader, D.M. Johns, and Victor Diaz. And it was created for, built on the need to amplify the voices of writers of colors, create community engagement amongst writers of colors, because at that time in 1999, only 0.2% of writers of colors were being published. Now we are celebrating 20 years and over 2,400 writers had attended VONA and more than 400 of them have been published.
That's wonderful.
And
that's
we
a
have
wonderful accomplishment.
Yeah, we have award-winning authors. We have Tajeri Jones. We have Juno Diaz. We have Lisa Cole. A variety of writers of colors that have been published that are bestsellers. There are, then they become faculty and teach the emerging writers that are coming up in our
That's
community.
Wonderful.
So we are very committed to have our stories told, and we mix our writing with social justice too.
Wonderful, thank you.
Thank you.
And so if somebody wanted to submit to VONA, how would they go about doing so?
Well, right now we have a new program, which is the VONA Across the Country, because, you know, we listen to our community and we are developing workshops in different cities around the country to make it accessible to our writers. So all they have to do is go to our website, bonavoices.org, and register.
Beautiful. And so before we go, I want to just tap into the Trailblazer series, right?
Yes.
Because that's new for you, too.
Excited.
Now you've ventured into podcasts, which is,
yes,
kind of the new trend now. You know, it's the new way. It's the new day and age of I guess, educating individuals or even, I guess, finding your niche in,
yes,
topics of discussion. And it seems to me you have a niche.
Yes.
Yeah.
Well, I team up with Mariela Regalado, and we had created an event back in 2016 called the Trailblazers, because we felt that as communities of colors, we don't get to see our people that are successful, that are making it, and we always following other people. And I was like, what about seeing people that look like us being successful and inspiring us to follow that trail? So we created the event, and then we needed something more. And we decide to go with the podcast. So in the podcast, we are having people within our network that we admire and inspire us to have in-depth conversations about their journey, their experience. And we just want to empower other trailblazers.
And how long does the podcast last per segment?
30 minutes.
A 30-minute segment, so it's really in-depth. And I understand you got Funk Master Flex in there.
Yes.
That's awesome.
Yes.
That's awesome. And I just wanted to throw that out there just so that they get an idea of what kind of people you're actually documenting.
Yes.
And I think it's important. And so before we go, what would you like to leave everybody with?
Well, I just want to let people know that it's all possible for all of us, and just follow your dream, but you have to do the work. It's not just dreaming, it's doing.
It is doing the work, and it's also connecting with people like Miss Wendy Angulo, who's producing us. So be sure to check out her website. Thank you, Wendy.
Thank you. Thank you, Rina.
And you guys, once again, for more on Wendy Angulo's upcoming projects, make sure to check her out by going to WendyAnguloProductions.com. We have to take a quick break, but when we return, we'll hear about a web series shot in a Bronx bodega. Don't go anywhere. We'll be right back.